how to target Google Shopping for multiple countries. In this video, I'm going to explain to you how do you get your products onto the free listings for Google Shopping, as well as how do you set it up for your Google Shopping ads so you can target multiple countries if that's what you're going for. Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps online store owners to grow and scale up profitable Google Shopping ads. If you're new to my channel, do download my free Shopify marketing guide, link in the description and pinned comments, where I go into the details, the pros and cons of free ways and paid ways to drive traffic so you don't 100% rely on Google. In order to successfully set up Google Shopping ads so you can target multiple countries, you need to set up your app for your Shopify store, that is the Google and YouTube app, and you need to set up a Google Ads account, and of course successfully set up a Google Merchants account and get it approved. If you have not set up your Google Merchant Center account yet, or you are in the process of setting up, maybe you want to check out two of my resources, How to Get Your Account Approved for Google Shopping, link in the top right hand corner of the screen, where I go into the steps and preparations you need to be aware of so you can get your Google Merchants account approved on your first attempt. But if you're encountering some problems with your Google Merchants account and it got suspended because of misrepresentation issues, you can also check out one of my other videos, link in the top right hand corner of the screen, where I talk about misrepresentation, what it is about, and what Google expects from you as a Shopify store owner to make those improvements and tweaks to make your store legit in front of Google so they will approve your account. Once you have your account approved, you would probably have set up an automated feed. Automated product feed. I hope you have done that instead of doing something manual, because you want your inventory to be synced up with Google Merchant Center. And that's where Google has all the information about the different products that you have, whether it is for ad or free listings. That's where you want your product's feed to be appearing. Let's head on to my computer, where I'll show you how you can set it up such that your products will be seen in the shopping results in multiple countries. Let's go. First, you log into Google Merchant Center. On the left-hand side of the navigation bar, click on Feeds, and you'll be able to see this screen that says Primary Feeds. And if you have set up an automated feed successfully, you'll be able to see Input Method, Content API, click on the Feed Name, and you'll be able to see this screen which allows you to edit the target countries. If you have one country over here, you can click on the pencil button to edit and add more countries. And this screen will show up, allows you to go into the search box over here, type the different names of the countries, they will pop up, you will edit, and it will appear on the right hand side of the screen, and you click on save, and that's it. At this point, you might be asking, what about if I want to run Google Shopping ads for multiple countries? What do I do? First of all, make sure that the countries that you want to be running Google Shopping ads for, you have set it up in the steps that I've shown you earlier. Once that's included, great. That means your product feed will be eligible to show in those countries. And if you want to set up a campaign, a shopping campaign, then you'll be able to do that in the Google Ads account. In Google Ads, there are two main ways that you can run your product ads for. If you decide to run a PMAX campaign or a standard shopping campaign, that's where your product ads will show up. And one thing I want you to really keep in mind, this is really important, to make sure that your campaigns stay profitable and it's easier to manage and improve. When you set up your campaign in the settings for targeting countries, only set up to a maximum of one country per campaign. Do not set up multiple countries for your campaign. I'm going to explain why. Most people, when they set up, they might say, right, I only want to set up one campaign so it's easier to manage, and I want to target many different countries. So they select multiple countries for that one campaign. Yes, it's possible to select that. Google does allow you to select multiple countries, but in terms of managing the profitability of your campaign and the scalability of your campaign, making it to be more efficient, it's not advisable to target more than one country just for the sake of convenience. This is because of four main reasons. Reason number one, simply because if you are targeting more than one country, you are trying to target a huge or gigantic group of people. Imagine this, let me give you an analogy. When you're in a small company with two or three people in your team, maybe you have only one manager. If you are the founder of the company, you're managing 2 to 3 employees. It's possible to manage that. And as your team grows, your company becomes bigger, you hire more people. Maybe your team grows up to 20 to 30 people, or maybe even up to 50 people. If everybody was to come to report to you, has a single owner, it becomes really difficult to manage. You don't have the time and energy to manage each one of them. You won't be able to give them the right amount of attention. You won't be able to resolve all the issues because there are just too many people to manage. In this case, you will decide to hire managers or people who can help to divide this huge company into different groups such that you can manage their performance and give them the help that they need to perform. This goes the same for your campaigns. If you're targeting multiple countries, if there are anything wrong with your campaign, you won't be able to see anything. You won't be able to see any distinct trends. You won't be able to see if there are any problems. You won't be able to fix any costs because you're targeting just too many people. You won't be able to see any trends at all. And that's why you only usually want to set it to target maximum of one country in general. So you will be able to manage the performance of the campaign. If there are certain ads that are doing better, or if there are certain groups of people clicking, you'll be able to pinpoint right exactly where are the trends and where are the areas that need improvements, or which are the areas that maybe you want to exclude going forward. In a country like United States, which is a very big country, you can also choose to target your campaigns to only show to specific people in a certain states or in certain cities. You group them together, maybe if they're in the same time zone, such that you'll be able to understand and spot any trends or specific behaviors. You can decide to maybe increase your clicks or put in more budget for specific cities because those ad campaigns in those cities or states are performing better. In a nutshell, target only a sizable amount of people such that you'll be able to manage and scale up in the middle to long term. Reason number two, different shoppers in different countries would have different behavior. In order to better understand which ad type or which product ad appeals better to people of specific countries, or there are different colors, so maybe in specific countries, they like specific colors, and the other countries, they would prefer a different color. So in this case, if you are running different campaigns for different countries, you will be able to know, right, for this color in this country, I want to put more money behind that for those variants. Whereas for other countries, maybe you will put more budget behind the other more popular products. When you try to combine different countries together, it becomes more difficult to understand which ad campaign is doing better, which countries is selling more, what's the profitability of showing ads to country A versus country B. Reason number three, different cost per click. The cost per click in different countries would differ, sometimes due to the volume of competitors, and of course, the size of the customers in that group. If there are more competition for the same group of people, maybe you need to bid for a higher cost per click versus another country which have less competitors, then maybe the cost per click could be lower. In this case, you will not be able to know because you're combining multiple countries in one singular campaign, making it difficult for yourself to identify which are the areas that you can improve or become more profitable. And that's why you want to make sure you're only targeting a maximum of one country per campaign. The cost per click, the click-through rate, and the conversion rate could be different in different countries. Maybe you need to pay more for the campaign in country A versus country B. And it makes it difficult for you to know when or which country should you put more ad budget for. If you want to improve your click-through rates for your Google Shopping campaign, you can also check out one of my videos, link in the top right-hand corner of the screen, where I go into 7 different ways to improve your click-throughs for your campaign, such that you get more shoppers to your store, people who are more likely going to become your best customers. Reason number four, different bank holidays. In different countries, there could be different festivals or different public holidays in different times of the year. And during those times, the shoppers' behavior would be different. If you combine different countries together in one singular campaign, you will not be able to understand when or how to adjust your campaign based on those differing behavior. The more countries you combine together, where they have different bank holidays at different times of the year, this means that your campaign will not have a consistent performance. There will be fluctuating behaviors during different times during those bank holidays. Because I'm sure you've noticed, like, when you're rushing to plan for a holiday, you might not necessarily have time to be shopping for products. Or if you're coming back from your holiday, it takes some time for you to get into this shopping phase online. So during those times, the behavior is not really consistent. And when you combine different countries, different people who have different holidays throughout the entire year, this makes it difficult for you to know when would the conversion rate be higher, or when would the click-through rate be higher or lower, or cost per click in this case. And this is why you should never put more than one target country in your standard shopping campaign, nor your PMAX campaign. In a nutshell, keeping it to one country or to a couple of states or cities if you have a big country. It helps you to identify any distinct trends that you have in your campaign so you can make any necessary adjustment to maybe the cost per clicks, to your ad budget, to understand what's the click-through rate and make any changes or adjustments to your ads. I hope this gives you a very strong reason why you should only be targeting only one country per shopping ad. If you should decide to target multiple countries, do run multiple different campaigns. Don't forsake the convenience of managing everything in a singular campaign versus the scalability and profitability of your campaigns in the long run. If you want to set the right foundations for long-term profitability for your campaigns, check out one of my other videos where I talk about long-term profitability with Google Shopping Ads, link in the top right-hand corner of the screen. And if you are deciding to run Google Shopping Ads, or if you've just started running Google Shopping Ads and you're not seeing any results yet, then you definitely want to check out my other video where I talk about, can you see results from Google Shopping Ads after 1 month? And what kind of results should you be expecting? Link in the top right-hand corner of the screen. Do check that out. If you're looking for professional help to scale up profitable Google Shopping Ads, do get in touch. My contact details in the description and pinned comments. I help store owners to double store traffic and sales by scaling up profitable Google Shopping Ads. And don't forget to download my free Shopify marketing guide. Link in the description and pinned comments where I go into the pros and cons of diversifying your traffic sources, different ways where you can drive free and paid traffic to your store such that you don't 100% rely on Google. Don't put all your eggs into one basket. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, remember to give it a like. Do subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss future videos on how to grow and scale up profitable Google Shopping Ads. I'm Clarice Lynn, ROI Doctor, signing off. Stay profitable. We'll be right back.